Today, we're looking into the fascinating world of twin flames. Now, if you've ever heard this term and wondered what it's all about, or if you're keen to know whether you've met your twin flame, stick around because we're covering it all. Twin flames are often seen as two halves of the same soul destined to find each other and unite. This concept has layers of spiritual, emotional, and even controversial elements. Over the next few minutes, we'll explore the different types of twin flames, the emotional and spiritual stages they go through, and the controversies that surround this concept. We'll also look into its historical context to get a full picture. So let's get started. Okay, so the first thing to know is that not all twin flames are created equal. Yep, there are different types, and each comes with its unique characteristics and connections. First off, we have monadic twin flames. These are believed to come from the same monad, or energy cluster, and they have a special mission to bring unconditional love to humanity. They're connected by what's known as a golden cord, a spiritual link that binds them together. Then there are split soul twin flames. These folks actually share a higher self. That's right, one higher self between the two of them. Past life regression is often used to reunite these types, helping them recall past incarnations where they might have been together. Last but not least, meet the Starseed Twins. They share a hive mind, which means they think alike in many ways. But what really sets them apart is that you can often identify these connections through a synastry chart. For those who might not know, a synastry chart is a tool in astrology that compares the planets in two people's birth charts to understand their relationship dynamics. Each of these types can be validated or identified through unique methods. For example, you might experience a premonition before meeting your twin flame, or even find yourself on the same intercontinental flight. It's like the universe aligning things for you. So now that you know the types, you might be wondering how this all plays out emotionally and spiritually. Well, don't go anywhere because up next we're diving into the emotional and spiritual journey of twin flames. So, you've heard about the different types of twin flames and how to identify them, but what happens once you've found your twin flame? Trust me, it's not all sunshine and rainbows. It's an emotional and spiritual roller coaster. First, there's the yearning stage. This is where you may feel an intense desire to find your soulmate, even if you don't yet know who they are. But here's where it gets interesting. Many people report experiencing telepathy or shared emotions with their twin flame at this stage. It's like your souls are already communicating. Then comes the notorious runner and chaser phase. One person, the runner, might become overwhelmed by the intensity of the connection and start pulling away. Meanwhile, the chaser is trying to close the gap. It's a dynamic that can be both exhilarating and exhausting. But why does this happen? A big part of it is tied to the concepts of divine male and divine female energies. These energies help us understand how twin flames mirror each other's actions and emotions. They complement each other, but they can also magnify each other's insecurities. And this leads to the more challenging stages, like the turmoil or testing period. This is where those insecurities and past traumas bubble to the surface. But it's also an opportunity for growth and transformation. The idea is to confront and resolve these issues, propelling both individuals toward a more harmonious union. The journey doesn't end there. There are more stages leading up to what's known as oneness, a stage where the twin flames have worked through their issues and reached a state of emotional and spiritual unity. But we'll get more into that later. So as you can see, the twin flame journey is not for the faint of heart. It can bring immense joy and spiritual growth, but it can also dredge up unprocessed traumas and insecurities. It's like the ultimate test of emotional readiness. Up next, we're going to tackle the controversial aspects of twin flames, including some criticisms that you won't want to miss. Stay tuned. All right, folks, let's get into something a little more serious now, the controversy surrounding twin flames. While the journey can be beautiful and spiritually enlightening, there are some red flags and important criticisms we should all be aware of. First and foremost, organizations like the National Coalition Against Domestic Violence, or NCADV, have pointed out that the dynamics in some twin flame relationships can unfortunately resemble those in abusive relationships. Traits like possessiveness and even forced intimacy can appear, and that's not something to gloss over. Now, it's crucial to say that not all twin flame relationships fall into this category. But the intense emotional and spiritual connection can sometimes blur the lines, leading to situations where both parties might not realize the harm that's being done. This is why experts recommend counseling for anyone in a twin flame situation, especially when going through tough phases like the runner and chaser dynamic, which we talked about earlier. So, while the twin flame connection can offer a profoundly transformative experience, it's also important to approach it with your eyes wide open. Emotional and spiritual growth cannot come at the expense of your well-being. If you're venturing into a twin flame relationship, make sure you're aware of both its enlightening aspects and its potential hazards. It's all about balance, folks, and ensuring you're in a connection that fosters mutual respect and growth. Now that we've talked about the types, stages, and even the controversies surrounding twin flames, let's add another layer to this by going back in time, way back to the times of Plato. Yep, you heard it right. The concept of twin flames isn't exactly new. In fact, it has roots in ancient philosophy. Plato's Symposium theory described love as the pursuit of wholeness, implying that we were once whole but were split and now seek our other halves. It's a concept that has fascinated humans for centuries, and it adds a certain timelessness to the whole twin flame idea. But wait, don't mix this up with soulmates or soul families. Although these terms often get thrown around interchangeably, they are not the same. Soulmates can come in many forms: friends, family, or romantic partners, and you can have multiple soulmates throughout your life. They serve various roles and help you grow in different ways. Twin flames, on the other hand, are considered to be the singular, transformative force. They push both parties toward a unique state of rebirth and oneness, which is way more intense than what you typically expect from a soulmate or a member of your soul family. So there you have it, a historical perspective combined with a differentiation from similar yet distinctly different spiritual relationships. Remember, the journey with a twin flame is not just another love story. It's a spiritual marathon pushing you toward intense growth. From the different types like monadic, split soul, and starseed twins to the emotional roller coaster they experience, and even the controversies that have sparked some serious debates, it's clear that the world of twin flames is as complex as it is captivating. But before we wrap up, let's take a moment to recognize the dual nature of this concept. On one hand, it's a deeply spiritual and transformative experience that pushes both individuals toward emotional growth and oneness. On the other hand, it can be fraught with emotional challenges and even dangers, making it crucial to approach the twin flame journey with immense emotional readiness and discernment. If you find yourself in a twin flame relationship, or even if you're just intrigued by it, remember that it's not just about the romantic allure or the emotional highs, it's also about being prepared for intense emotional and spiritual growth, which might involve dealing with unprocessed insecurities and traumas. So, whether you're a believer, a skeptic, or just curious, the one thing to take away is that the twin flame journey is not for the faint of heart. It's a transformative experience that calls for commitment to spiritual development, individual growth, and well-being. And that's a wrap for today. If you found this video helpful or intriguing, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more content like this. Feel free to drop your thoughts or questions about twin flames in the comments below. And who knows, maybe we'll do a follow-up video addressing those. Until next time, take care.